before getting into property, we need to first understand what is temperature, right, and what is heat, and how they are different from each other. Can you tell me what is temperature? What it is?
Measure of hotness or coldness.
What do you mean by that? Measure of hotness means what?
To give it a specific value. Heat is just energy, but whereas temperature specifies the value.
No, but heat can also be specified, right? Heat is energy, so it can be written in the in form of joules.
It's relative. Temperature.
Heat is a flow of energy. Heat flows, or heat goes. Heat energy goes from one object to the other object. Okay, just like water flows from one point to the other point. Why water flows from one point to other point? Because of the pressure difference. Right, because of the pressure difference, water flows, and because of the temperature difference, heat flows. Okay, so you can draw parallel with, let's say, fluids, and try to understand it. Okay, and if you go to the micro level, as in what it is exactly. Okay, suppose gas molecules are there in this room. Okay, I am talking about what is heat. I mean, what happens to the gas molecule if the temperature increases? If the temperature increases, the kinetic energy of gas molecule increases. Okay? So what happens is that when a gas molecule hit your hand, then it will transfer its little bit of kinetic energy into your hand. Okay? And you'll feel the heat. Getting it? So if there's a lot of transfer of energy from the gas molecule on your hands, you'll feel that more amount of heat is there. Are you getting it? Now, temperature is a measure of, indirectly it is a measure of how much is the kinetic energy in the gas. Right? More is the kinetic energy in the gas, more it can transfer. Are you getting it? So temperature in a way is a measure of kinetic energy of the gas molecules. Okay, now what is pressure? Pressure also happens because of gas molecules. What is that?
Force.
When the force gets exerted, when the gas molecules collide, okay, they will not only transfer the energy, they will transfer the momentum also. Fine, that transfer of momentum creates the force. Rate of change of momentum creates the force, and that creates the pressure. And the transfer of energy creates the flow of heat. Getting it? Now, the problem is that we cannot go about looking at the gas molecule and then try to say that, okay, temperature is, I mean, rather than temperature, you best way was that you just find out the kinetic energy of the molecules, all of it, and then say that, okay, just forget about temperature, this is the kinetic energy. But it becomes a very tedious process and inaccurate process. Fine. So there is this term called temperature, which is defined, coined, which tells you, you know, relatively what is the kinetic energy of the molecules. Getting it? All right. So this is what the temperature is, and there had been a lot of research, as in past, to just quantify what it is, because during those days people were trying to quantify each and everything defined. Like, for example, length was quantified. Okay, this much is 1 meter, this much is probably 1 feet, like that they have quantified. Okay, and similarly they have quantified mass, time, and everything they have quantified. But when it comes to something like temperature, they were not able to quantify it very well. The reason is that when I say zero length, what does it mean? 0 meters means nothing is there. Less than zero length is not possible. Getting it? Simply, less than 0 kg is not possible. So there is absolute zero there. You cannot go below that. Right? Similarly, you need to define the temperature in such a way that zero means zero. Are you getting it? But nobody was able to find during that time what is zero, what is absolute zero. Fine. So that is the reason why they could not identify an absolute scale. So they took the help of the most common thing available to everyone, which is what? Water. Okay. And with respect to water, they have come up with a scale to measure the temperature. Is this thing understood? Right. So, but then when they have defined, they will assume something to be zero. They will say, okay, fine, well, the water freezes at 0 degrees Celsius. But is less than zero possible? Yes, it is possible. So that zero is not absolute zero. Are you getting it? That's just a relative zero. It is zero with respect to the water at that level. Getting it? So, degree Celsius scale is defined. Write down. This temperature scale is defined what happens is when you know the absolute scale, for example, for length we know 0 is 0, so all you have to do is define what is 1 meter, then 2 meter is double of that, 3 meter is triple of that, like that it becomes straightforward thing. But when it comes to relative scale, you need to first assume what is 0 and then you have to assume what is 1. Get it? So the assumption here is that, write down, the temperature of ice is assumed to be 0 degrees Celsius. Just like you assume gravitational potential energy to be 0 at some horizontal level, even though it is not. Getting it? Like that, we are assuming something to be 0 degrees Celsius, which is temperature of ice. Okay, and then we are assuming temperature of boiling water to be 100 degrees Celsius. All this is happening at 1 atmosphere. Fine. Okay, and between ice and this boiling point, entire scale is divided into 100 equal parts. Okay, so it's a linear scale, fine, equally spaced intervals from 0 to 100. Any doubts? Now, if I have defined a scale like this, can you get an idea of what is 150? You just move one step, whatever you have defined, you know exactly what is 1, right? So after 100, you just add 50 of 1s. So you get 150, right? So that's how Celsius scale is defined. Okay? And then, during the same time, in England, there was this Fahrenheit scale that was developed. Degree Fahrenheit, they call it. Fahrenheit scale. Here, they have taken some other bases. They haven't taken water. I'm not actually very sure what bases they had taken, but they have taken the bases in such a way that the temperature of melting ice, and this is melting ice, okay? This is melting ice, because ice can be at less than 0 degrees Celsius also, but melting ice has to be at 0. Okay, so temperature of melting ice is 32 degree Fahrenheit. Okay, and temperature of boiling water, any idea what it is? Remember? No? 212 degree Fahrenheit. Okay? Any doubts till now? No? Both are linear scale. As in between 32 and 212, what is the difference? 212 and 32? 180? Right? So 180 equal divisions are there. Here 100 equal divisions are there. Okay? Now, if I tell you a temperature in degree Celsius, can you convert into Fahrenheit or vice versa? Can you do that? Try to see whether you can derive it. Assume that temperature in degree Celsius scale is C. What is F? Anyone, how will you go about it? Any idea?
Yeah, take the ratio.
The division is 0 divided by 100 minus 0 would be equal to F divided by 200 minus 0. Why? Acha, tell me this. If I plot this graph. Suppose on y-axis you have Fahrenheit and on x-axis you have degree Celsius. Okay? Will it be a straight line? Will it be a straight line? It has to be. Both are linear scales. Okay? Both are linear scale. So there will be a straight line equation between F and C. Okay? Can you find out the line? Can you plot a line? Do that. You have 2 points, right?
We can just find the slope.
I mean that's the way you have to do it. Since it is a straight line, the slope should be same. Try to do this. What is the first point? When degree Celsius is 0, Fahrenheit is 32, so this is the first point. 0, 32. Okay. Second point, 212, 100, 212. So this point is 100, 212. Fine. So you have this as your straight line. Fine. Now, since it is a straight line, the slope should be constant, right? So you just assume a random point somewhere here whose coordinates are C, F. Okay? Take these 2 points initially and then these 2 points. Equate the slope from 2 point formula. This is A, B, and C. So if you take A and C, the slope should be 212 minus 32 divided by 100 minus 0. This should be equal to F minus 32 divided by C minus 0. Any doubts? So we have F minus 32 divided by 180 is equal to C by 100. Okay? So C is equal to 5 by 9 F minus 30. Right? So this is how you can, you know, derive a relation between degree Celsius and Fahrenheit. Any doubts? So if I give you a temperature in degree Celsius, you should be able to convert in degree Celsius. Now people didn't stop there. They were always trying to find out, is there any absolute scale? Okay? So in that particular quest, there was one experiment that was conducted with gases. Okay, so let's see what is that experiment. this is the temperature and this one is the pressure. Okay. Now they have taken a gas at a particular pressure and temperature. So this is the initial pressure and temperature. Okay. Now they are cooling it down. What will happen to its temperature? Down. Pressure? Down. Okay. So next point is observed. Okay. Then again they are cooling it down. Another point is observed. So like that, when they are connecting it, they're getting like this, a straight line, and after this point the gas liquefies, it changes the state, fine. But if you extend the line, you know that pressure cannot be less than zero. Okay, so when pressure is zero, they are trying to find what could have been the temperature. So this gas liquefied because it's a real gas, it's not an ideal gas. Had it been the ideal gas, it will not liquefy and it will just come and hit here. And this temperature is minus of 273.15 degrees Celsius. Okay, now this is for only one gas, let's say gas 1. Okay, similarly they have taken another gas, alright. Now, when they have taken another gas, they are trying to liquefy it, they are trying to decrease the temperature. Its temperature decreased and then, to their surprise, it came and meet the same point. When pressure is zero, the temperature of both the gases appear to be at same point. Okay? This, and no matter which gas you take, approximately all the gases, they are converging at the same temperature, as if there is something unique for that temperature, something unique about this temperature. Okay, what is that unique thing? Temperature cannot go below this because negative pressure is not defined, it's not possible. Fine. So, if temperature cannot go below this, what does it mean? This is the absolute temperature. This is the absolute zero. Okay. So, there comes a new scale, which is an absolute scale. So, since it is an absolute scale, we don't call it degree. Degree is a relative term. Like degree Celsius, degree Fahrenheit. It's a relative comparison with some substance. Kelvin is not a comparison. It's an absolute scale. Okay? So, a Kelvin scale is defined. Write down. Kelvin temperature scale. Is defined in such a way that 0 Kelvin is actually minus of 273.15 degrees Celsius. Sorry, yeah. 0 Kelvin is this, and change in temperature in Kelvin delta, as in 1 Kelvin is change of 1 Kelvin is equal to change of 1 degree Celsius. Getting it? So delta T in Kelvin is equal to delta T in degree Celsius. They are equal. Fine? So you will see lot of formulas in this chapter where delta T will come. Okay? So you don't need to convert degree Celsius into Kelvin or Kelvin into degree Celsius because both delta T's are same. Okay? But if suppose there is a formula in which only T is coming, like sigma E A T raised to power 4, there is no delta T. There you need to convert temperature into Kelvin, which is an absolute scale. Okay? This happens to the to be the SI unit also for temperature, Kelvin. Okay, any doubts? No. Now can you tell me, if the temperature is C degree Celsius, or let's say X degree Celsius, what is its temperature in Kelvin? How much that should be? X plus 273.15. Okay, so this much temperature in degree Celsius is equivalent to X plus 273.15 Kelvin. Okay, and just so that our calculation is simpler, we many times ignore 0.15, we just say 273. We just add 273 degree Celsius to arrive at the SI unit of the temperature, which is Kelvin. Fine? Any doubt with introduction to temperature? Right? So this is how we measure the temperature. Once you know how you can measure the temperature, now you can talk about the thermal properties one by one. Okay? Now, like what we have discussed, you know, you can devise your own way of measuring temperature. You can have a gas trapped inside a container, and you can define in such a way temperature that pressure when ice is melting at that temperature, you know, that pressure corresponds to some temperature, and that boiling water, what is the pressure inside that container, corresponds to some other temperature. So you can develop and scale yourself. You're getting my point? Okay, so don't feel afraid of solving such questions, because if you go and solve some higher level questions, they will twist the question in such a way that many times you assume that okay, fine, this is Kelvin scale, this is degree Celsius scale, this is Fahrenheit scale, and that's it. But what happens is that a good question will test you on the basics, whether you have understood how the scales are defined. They will give a scenario in such a way that they'll say, okay, assume there is a new temperature scale that has developed. So these are conditions. So you need to be very good at analyzing the situation. Right? But then that will come through problem practice. We'll do it a bit later.